All right, real quick.
Ooh.
Valentine's Day is here, and love is in the air. Well, actually, a more accurate thing to say is our brains are hopped up on oxytocin. So what is oxytocin, and why is it considered the love hormone? Well, oxytocin is a neuropeptide, which means that it's a short-chain polypeptide that's used as a neurotransmitter, relaying a signal from one neuron to another. Oxytocin is released by the pituitary gland and binds to oxytocin receptors, which can be found on cells in the brain as well as the rest of the body. Oxytocin is crucial during the delivery of a baby. It helps with cervical dilation and contractions. Then, during breastfeeding, oxytocin gets released in response to a baby's suckling or even a baby's cry as part of the reflex that allows milk to be let down from the nipples. But oxytocin affects everyone, not just mothers. It promotes generosity and trust, decreases fear, and even helps people recover from negative social interactions. Oxytocin is also incredibly important for pair bonding, like in romantic relationships, increasing mood and feelings of attachment. And it's even thought to help with sexual arousal and orgasms. But it also plays a role in platonic relationships. For example, oxytocin levels rise in humans and dogs after they've spent time petting or playing together. However, for all its rosy effects, oxytocin does have some thorns.
Ooh.
Oxytocin facilitates bonding among people with shared characteristics, meaning that it makes us favor people that are like us in some way and have a bias against people who aren't like us. All of this to say that oxytocin plays a complex and nuanced role in the body. Happy Valentine's Day.
Hi guys, Vince here. I'm a manager of video creation here at Osmosis, but you might recognize me from my cameo in our Valentine's Day special on oxytocin, the love hormone. And don't worry, we're just playing around with the format for special occasions and holidays for fun. We're not doing anything to our regular content that includes high-yield medical information or our regular schedule. In fact, we're committed to making more of these kinds of videos. So we've been hiring script writers, script reviewers, medical illustrators, and professional video editors in order to make more of these kinds of videos. These videos include topics that cover pathophysiology, physiology, embryology, the essentials of ECG, and more. So, in addition to the new videos that we release every week on YouTube, we've been uploading about 10 videos a week to our website at osmosis.org. So if you're interested in these kinds of videos, check us out. And of course, we have other tools that'll help you learn medicine. These include quizzes, flashcards, study schedule organizers, and more. So if you're interested in that kind of thing, again, check us out at osmosis.org. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. And until next time, see ya.